Hello everyone, Omores here. Today we are checking out two special Voodoo cards from SDZMods.com. First, we have a Voodoo 4400H, and second, we have a Voodoo 4440H. SDZ Mods is not selling these cards, but they provide schematics so you can make your own special Voodoo card. For this, you have to know how to deal with a site like PCBWay or GLC PCB. If not, you can still find ready-to-buy custom Voodoo cards like those from King Shaman series, but at $750 a piece, you might want to take a look on those schematics from SDZ Mods.
Here we are using technology to save the planet. Our tiny chip. It does 100 billion operations per second. That is power most awesome. And we are using it to make a difference. Imagine clean air, pure water, and a new future. I wish my family back home could see me now. We are most proud knowing that we are doing our part to help save the planet.
Attention, everybody. We're going to forget that environment stuff and use a chip for computer games. Back to work.
<clears throat> 3dfx PC accelerators. So powerful, it's kind of ridiculous.
Blast his freaking head off!
Voodoo 1 was released in late 1996, and it was a piece of hardware everyone wanted in their computer until, of course, Voodoo 2 was announced in late 1997. Now let's build a typical 1997 PC as a host for our Voodoo cards. Let's go with a Pentium 200 MMX. The CPU was released in January 1997. Pentium 2 was also released in mid-1997, but the launch prices didn't make much sense, so a Pentium MMX was a way more popular choice. The motherboard is a Soltek SL-3D5 with a VIA VPX chipset, also released in January 1997. This is an AT motherboard. No problem, it's still compatible with an ATX case. I actually have a horizontal case from Cooler Master, which is more time appropriate, I guess, but I'm not so sure I'm gonna use it this way. There were some bent pins on this CPU, but nothing extraordinary. I have seen way worse than this. Now it's okay. This is a PS2 header. We're gonna need it for our PS2 mouse. This is a PC Winner AT power source. We have a Medalist Pro hard drive, very fast. This is a typical 2D/3D card from S3. This is, of course, our Voodoo 4400H with one TMU and HDMI output and 8 megabytes of RAM. And finally, let's use a Creative Sound Blaster, and not any Sound Blaster, but maybe the only ISA card that no one would swap it for a PCI card in 1997. In this ATX case, there is a possibility to mount an AT-style power button, but it's not gonna happen today, since some modifications are still needed. We'll let the switch in the on position, and we will start our PC from the power cord. And here we go. Since this is a 1997 PC, we will stick with Windows 95 and 128 megs of RAM, which wasn't typical back in the day, but we still have plenty of money left because remember, we didn't buy a $2,000 Pentium 2 CPU. Even if we use a custom Voodoo card with more memory, no special drivers are needed. A Voodoo 1 card was designed to happily accept up to 12 megabytes of RAM. The HDMI output is a custom design from SDZ Mods and it works on its own. Unfortunately, the signal wasn't compatible with my capture card, so all the footage is still from the VGA output. But I know it works. There are plenty of videos captured over HDMI on SDZ Mods channel if you want to check them out. Now let me introduce you in the world of software rendering as of 1997. Voodoo 1 was sold as a 3D accelerator, and indeed graphics needed acceleration from dedicated hardware. Otherwise, a high-end CPU and a $150 S3 Virge 2D card barely handled 640 by 480 software rendering in Quake 1, released in the summer of 1996. So this is WinQuake at 640 by 480 in software rendering. For some reason, my capture card stretched the resolution. Anyway, how many FPS do we get? Let's see. Well, and we have 15 FPS. Not that bad, but now let's see what the Voodoo can do. Well, according to this classic internet picture, which is online like forever, I guess since the release of Voodoo 1, we should get 30 FPS. Apart from the extra memory, this is still a Voodoo 1, and let's see. And voila, we get 30 FPS, while everything looks way better. Can we ask for more? Yes, we can. Meet Voodoo 4440H with an extra texturing mapping unit, or TMU. An extra TMU would make a Voodoo 1 card like 30% faster, while no extra drivers are required. Back in the day, such cards were manufactured by Quantum 3D, a spin-off from 3dfx. This is SB504220 with an extra TMU added via a daughter board. And now we know why these Voodoo cards have these model numbers. Let's see now what an extra TMU can do. Well, not bad, 41.6 FPS from a Voodoo 1. Hexen is another 1997 release. It's based on a Quake 1 engine, so the frame rate should be almost the same. Time demo command didn't work as expected, but the frame rate is over 30 FPS for sure. Another 1997 release, it's Need for Speed 2 Special Edition. As you would expect, Need for Speed 2 runs smooth and looks good.
3, 2, 1, go!
And now it's time to test a late 1997 release, Quake 2, which is way more demanding. In a software mode, at the lowest resolution, we get only 17.3 FPS. Now let's use our accelerator and see what's gonna change. Definitely it looks way better. Now let's run a time demo.
Sector 4
21.5 FPS. This is better, not great. Now let's see what an extra TMU can do. Even better, but still not great. No problem, it's 1998, Voodoo 2 is out, and it's 3 times faster with screaming performance at over 60 frames per second. So I guess this is the end for Voodoo 1, or maybe not. We're gonna check in the next episode 1998 games like Half-Life, Unreal, and maybe some DOS games. Also, maybe I'll find a way to use the HDMI output. Until then, thanks for watching, stay tuned for the next episode.